I always say that saints are mystic. They come any time, in any country, any age. They have the same message to deliver to us. They have the same spiritual truth which they like to share with us and lead us back to the Father. Every mystic emphasizes on this point on the necessity of going back to the Father. We all realize how miserable we are in the separation. We are all miserable. Some may be more comfortably miserable, comfortably living in misery. But in separation from the Father, nobody can become happy. So their main mission is to unite us back to the Father. They don't come here to create any religion or to set one against the other. They only come to unite our soul back to the Father. That is why Christ said, I have not come for peace, I have come with sword. Don't think that by my coming to this world will become a place of paradise. I have just come to cut your attachments which are binding you to this creation and take you back to the Father. That is their main mission in life. They explain to us that our soul is the draw of the divine ocean. And the Lord is nowhere outside. He is within every one of us. He very beautifully explained, repent, kingdom of God is at hand. Our kingdom of God is within you. So Lord is nowhere outside. He is within every one of us. But unless we repent for what we have done in the past, though He may be within every one of us, we cannot reach Him, we cannot see Him. Now, how can we repent? Because we do not know what we have done in the past. We can only repent of what we are conscious, of what we know. These are our sins which we have committed in ignorance in our previous life. Christ said that you will be born in sin, that if we don't realize the Father within, then we may have to take birth along with our sins which we have committed in this lifetime. So in every lifetime we are collecting sins one after the other, which is a big load on our soul. So we have to seek His forgiveness. Only then we can go back to Father. Christ said, light is within every one of us, but darkness comprehended not. The light of that Father, it shines within every one of us, irrespective of past and creed. But we do not see that light which can lead us back to our home because due to the darkness. This darkness is our attachments. Our mind is attached to the senses. Our mind is attached to this creation. So we have created this great darkness between us and the Father. Unless we are able to eliminate that veil of darkness from within us, we will not see that light. And unless we see that light, we cannot be led back to our home. So how to illuminate that darkness? Christ said in St. John, there was a man who had come from God. His name was John. He is referring to John the Baptist. As far as he was concerned, he said, I have been able to illuminate that darkness from within myself through St. John. And St. John was sent from the Father to my level. So he means to explain that unless somebody comes to our level, from the level of the Father, and being at our level is also at the level of the Father, we will not be able to illuminate that veil of the darkness. We will not be able to see that light which gives us life and which leads us back to our Father. So he says we have to find some mystic, we have to find some saint who can help us to illuminate that darkness. And then he explained to us that Moses gave you the law, but truth has come through Jesus. Meaning Moses gave you the same teaching. No mystic brings any new teaching. No saint brings any shortcut for us to go back to Father. They have the same teaching right from the time of the creation, and they will remain the same till the end of the creation. Teachings never change. So he says, Moses gave you the law. Which law? That cosmic law, which has created this universe and which governs this universe, which governs the soul and back to the level of the Father. And that law, the mystics come to share with us. So he explained to us that whenever a mystic comes, whenever a saint comes to our level, he explained to us that unless you illuminate that veil of darkness by attaching yourself to the divine melody within, by attaching yourself to the divine cosmic law which the Lord has kept within every one of us, you will not be able to illuminate this veil of the darkness. Because our soul and mind are not all together. In the body, their seat is here at the eye center, and mind is fond of pleasures, so it always remains slave of the senses. And being slave of the senses, we are collecting new karmas, lot of sins. So our soul is immortal. It shines. It is whole. But having taken association of the mind, it has lot of wrapping around the soul. Unless we are able to unwrap all those covering from the soul, it cannot shine, it cannot give its own refulgence, it cannot give its own light, and it cannot become pure, it cannot become whole, it cannot become worthy to become one with the Father. So Christ explained to us that we have to withdraw our mind from the sensual pleasures. Unless we are able to withdraw the mind to the eye center and attach ourselves to the divine melody within, we will not be able to illuminate that veil of the darkness. He says, if thy eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. So we have to withdraw from the nine apertures and bring our consciousness back to the eye center. So when we are here, then that third eye, our tenth aperture opens, and then we see that refulgence, then we see that light. Soul has power to hear, soul has power to see. So we, the divine, the soul sees that light, the soul hears that sound of that melody. With the help of that sound within, we know the direction of our house. And we can only detach ourselves from this creation when we are attached to that melody which he has kept within every one of us. Pleasure of that Shabdana, which is referred to in the Bible by so many words, Christ calls it law also, spirit also, Holy Ghost also, logos also, and different mystics have explained the same creative power, same creative cosmic law by different words. So we are not concerned with the word, we are concerned with that creative power. Who has created that creation, who sustains that creation, who governs that creation, and who can pull us back from the level of the creation back to the level of the Creator. And that